We present a modified quadcopter design that uses passive hinges to enable a number of behaviors, including flight through narrow tunnels, simple grasping, perching on wires, and passage through small gaps in projectile motion. The main significant difference between the proposed vehicle and a conventional quadcopter is the use of passive hinges that allow each arm of the vehicle to rotate freely between the unfolded and folded configurations. Note that no additional actuators or sensors are required beyond those used by a conventional quadcopter. These additional unactuated degrees of freedom enable the vehicle to hover with two opposing arms folded. This is achieved by reversing the thrust directions of the propellers attached to the two folded arms. Because the vehicle is designed such that the thrust axes of the folded arms are offset from one another, a yaw torque is produced that counteracts the yaw torque produced by the unfolded arms. We utilize this new ability in a number of ways. First, by folding two of the arms, one of the dimensions of the vehicle is significantly reduced, allowing for flight in tight spaces that would be impassable in the unfolded configuration. Here we show the vehicle using this property to fly through a narrow tunnel which the vehicle would be unable to traverse in the unfolded configuration in a near hover state, even with perfect accuracy. Next, we demonstrate the use of the vehicle to perform a simple grasping task where a box is moved from one location to another. After landing, the two arms are used to firmly pinch the box before taking off, after which the box is moved to a target location by the vehicle. Note that this task requires a specially sized box, and the allowable mass of the box is significantly limited by the maximum vertical thrust the vehicle can produce with two arms folded. Another task enabled by the free rotation of each arm is the ability of the vehicle to perch on hanging wires. When all four arms are folded, the center of mass of the vehicle is shifted below where the wire contacts the vehicle, leading to a stable perching configuration without the need for any specialized mechanism. Finally, we demonstrate the ability of the vehicle to fold all four arms simultaneously in order to traverse narrow gaps in projectile motion. After a short trajectory used to gain upward velocity, each of the four propellers are spun in reverse in order to fold the arms. While the arms are folded, the attitude of the vehicle is controlled by varying the reverse thrust forces produced by each propeller. Finally, the propellers again change rotation direction, thus unfolding the arms. Note that when flying in the unfolded configuration, the vehicle has similar tracking performance and power consumption compared to a conventional quadcopter. Here we show the vehicle flying a figure 8 trajectory specifically designed to require large yaw torques. The vehicle cannot produce as large yaw torques as a conventional quadcopter because it must satisfy constraints on the propeller thrust forces that prevent the arms from folding, resulting in larger yaw tracking errors when this constraint becomes active. However, the roll and pitch torques and total thrust the vehicle can produce are generally not affected by this bound, resulting in nearly identical position tracking performance compared to a conventional quadcopter.